So what are you about to do?
Every morning, Anna and I meet and we go over last night's show.
You seem nervous.
Nervous? No. I'm not nervous. I mean, why would you say I'm nervous? I mean, it's my show. You know, if I wanted to go start this meeting right now, I could. In fact, that is what I'm going to do.
Not now, please.
Yep. I wasn't really ready for that meeting either, so that works out pretty good for both of us.
Look, can you give Seth a message for me? This sketch is way too long. Does he think it's War and Peace? What's my next appointment?
A lot of people don't realize that, along with being a fashion icon, Anna Wintour has been behind every major comedy decision in the last 40 years. Saturday Night Live was her idea. She directed Animal House. She told Jerry Seinfeld the show should be about nothing.
So how would you characterize your relationship with Anna?
Oh, great. She and I very much have an equal partnership at this show.
How would you characterize your relationship with Seth?
Teacher student.
Like the type of relationship where the student becomes a teacher and you learn from the student?
No.
When we found out Anna Wintour was the executive producer of our show, all the writers started wearing tuxedos and ball gowns. She never actually said that's what she wanted, but we just assumed that was the right thing to do.
I don't know why they do that. They look ridiculous. So, Seth, I don't understand this part of the sketch.
What?
Well, why is Abraham Lincoln driving a BMW?
Well, because it's funny.
Wouldn't it be much funnier if he was driving a Lincoln?
Is it funnier if Abraham Lincoln is driving a Lincoln?
Of course it's funnier.
Well, if we're being totally honest, I would say Anna is the creative engine behind the show. Like, every decision goes through her.
Astronaut, what's next? Chattering teeth, what's next? Larger bottle. What's next, please?
You know, when people ask me where I work, I just say Late Night with Anna Wintour, or The Anna Wintour Show, or just Anna.
Do you find yourself trying to please Anna?
Please? No. No. Absolutely not. Now, do I try to make her happy by doing a job that will satisfy and delight her? Yes, sure.
Isn't that the definition of please?
On one side we have measles, on the other side we have Justin Bieber, and in the middle we have things we thought we'd gotten rid of. No response, Anna? Nothing? Just gonna sit there with your sunglasses on? I have a question. Did the sun rise in the studio or something? Because you should throw some suntan lotion on that nose of yours, Anna. I'd hate for you to get a sunburn here in this dark studio. Hey, everyone, good morning. Let's all put on our sunglasses, and we can be like Anna Wintour.
Are you done?
Yes. So I put Abraham Lincoln in a Lincoln, and then I put Gerald Ford in a Volvo, but the Volvo thing comes later in the sketch, so I think it's a pretty funny switch.
Good. Thank you, Seth. You can go.
You seem happy.
Oh, yeah. I mean, look, it's great when you get her approval. You know, she pushes you really hard, but, you know, the sketch is 100 times better than it was this morning. I try so hard.
Stop crying. You're a grown man.
You guys gotta give me a heads up when she's behind me.
How do you feel about working at Late Night?
I love this job. Because I love to laugh.